Welcome, please have a seat.
Hi, my name is Tom, I'm from Israel. I have a question for both actors. Could you define David Fincher's style of working with actors?
You start.
I don't know if anything about David Fincher can be defined in a neat little box. I don't know how I would define it. I mean, I think David's incredibly collaborative, and he's willing to just work things out. I mean, that's kind of one of the great things about doing that many takes, is you really get to try every single way, and you don't have to stop until you really figure it out and find it. I don't know how I would... How would you define...
I don't know, but it's. I think he likes actors, not necessarily as people, but he likes actors because of what they can do and what he can find in them. So he lets them go on forever and try things, but it's also extremely focused on the set. There's no, you don't do any bullshit talk, or there's no laziness. Everything is extremely focused. And everybody's working for the same purpose and in the same direction, which is a very pleasant environment. But then he doesn't mess too much with you. He probably is very cautious when he casts, and then just let you go, basically. But he comes in there and fiddles a little. But there was one actor who said to David, after several takes, that she thought she was wrong, she was doing the wrong thing, but she wasn't really. It was just that Fincher wanted more. And she said, "Thank you for being so tolerant." And David answered, "I'm not tolerant. I'm patient."
I don't think David treats any two actors the same, because he definitely messed with me a lot. So he didn't mess with you, but I guess.
Yeah, but you're smaller than me.
And what was it like to be here for such a long period?
It was wonderful. It was hard. You know, it's hard. There were nights where we had people out on a bridge with blowtorches trying to get ice off so that we could have people chase people on motorcycles. And that was... That was difficult. That was not something I'd ever experienced before. I'd never been in a situation where we had to bring in a salt truck just so that we could make stuff safe. But shooting in the city was a lot easier. But I don't know. It was. I didn't want to do it, and I didn't want to transplant the story to Montreal. And when I got here, it made perfect sense that This is where the fiction sprang from. This is the world that he was talking about, and it made sense that that's what it should look like.
Okay. Vad var ditt intryck av skådespelarna? Stellan Skarsgård och Rooney Mara?
Stellan Skarsgård var ju den som fick liksom humoristens roll på presskonferensen, som hade lite catchy saker att säga och så här. Rooney Mara var ganska tystlåten, och det känns som att hon har lite svårt för att prata om Lisbeth Salander, om varför hon vill spela det och vad hon tycker om rollen. Och det känns som att hon inte riktigt vet vad som kommer att hända när den här filmen går ut över hela världen om en månad. Jag tror det kan komma som en liten chock för henne att hon plötsligt blir Lisbeth Salander för hela världen.
Många svenskar har ju redan sett den svenska versionen av den här filmen. Hur tror du att den här Hollywood-produktionen kommer att tas emot av den svenska publiken?
Jag skulle kunna tänka mig att ungefär lika många kommer att se den här som så den svenska. Dels är det så otroligt många som älskar Stieg Larssons böcker. Och sen tror jag många tycker att det är häftigt att en av Hollywoods absolut bästa regissörer har gjort en så otroligt påkostad filmversion av samma historia. Och i Stockholm också.